Namaste. Today I have come to a lift to explain to you a concept in yoga. If you observe the functioning of a lift, whether it is going up or coming down, there is a fight between resistance and action. When the lift goes up, the gravitational pull doesn't allow the lift to go up. So the motors of the lift have to put energy to raise the car. Similarly, when the lift comes down, it does not fall free. If you look on the other end of the rope, there is a counterweight. So the counterweight resists the car from going down. So when the car goes down, it has to lift this counterweight, which is artificially created. So when the lift comes down, it has to lift this counterweight, whereby the free fall is prevented. So whether it is going up or whether it is coming down, there is a fight between resistance and action. Let me take this concept to my yoga mat. Now I have brought the concept of resistance versus action into my yoga mat. I am in Janushirshasana position. I am going to bend forward and try to bring my body towards the leg. So I inhale and take my arms up. And then I exhale and bend forward. And try to bring my body closer to the leg. The more I bend, the leg is giving me a resistance. It is not allowing me to bend against it. But my mind is pushing my body towards the leg. So you can see the leg is resisting the action, whereas the mind is taking the action. So there is a fight between the resistance of the leg and the action of the body. It's a healthy fight. Both are benefited, the mind as well as the body. Now let me go to another scenario. I'm in a plank position. I'm going to go down to the floor, a low plank position. So when I go down, the body wants to fall like this. Okay, the body wants to fall because it is in the direction of gravity. It is not going to give me any resistance. Here, I will create an artificial resistance. So the mind creates a resistance here. You can observe. So I'm here, the body wants to fall. The mind will not allow to fall. So you can see here, the mind created a resistance against the body's tendency to fall free. Did you observe? In the first case, the body was creating a resistance against the mind. In the second case, the mind created a resistance against the body. Now, this is the concept which I want to explain today. If you observed the lift when it was going up, there is a natural gravitational pull which resists the action. And when the lift was coming down, there is an artificial resistance created by the counterweights. Or in some lifts, there are brakes to do that. Similarly, when you're practicing yoga asanas, different parts of the body will create a natural resistance and the mind has to work against that resistance. And certain other scenarios, the mind has to create a resistance artificially so that the body does not fall free. So I have observed in most of the situations in yoga practice, this fight between resistance and action prevails. And when this action prevails and you strike an equilibrium between them, there yoga resides. So when you're practicing yoga asanas, try to watch out for this phenomena, a resistance versus an action and an equilibrium between them. a resistance and an action. Namaste.